he came up with this beautiful quote that's going to be, his saying is going on this rock, so I think that's fantastic. And earlier today, we were at Closter Park, and several of the gentlemen that were at Closter Park, they took this group picture and with the big boulder coming down, and it's just fantastic. So I want to thank Ms. Martinez and her staff and the National Steinbeck. Thank you.
So you will have a tourist destination in your district. All right, Janet.
Just a couple of things. One, I wanted to address some misnomers that are out in the community. And if anyone in the community has any questions or concerns regarding council members' expenditures, travel expenses, etc., it's a matter of public record and is legally available for your perusal. Leave it at that. And secondly, I just wanted to mention about the California League of Cities published salaries that Mr. Jorgens is referring to. I was proud that our city manager is mid-range and he's worth every penny of it.
Okay. All right, Gloria.
I just want to remind the public and the community that we're starting flu season, and being a nurse, I just want to remind everyone that if you believe in getting immunizations, you need to get your flu shot. If you're a senior, you need to get your Pneumovax against pneumonia. And also, you're hearing a lot about the whooping cough. Monterey County right now has 77 cases reported. So. And infants, it's very critical in infants. Infants are dying. So again, remember, whooping cough, there's protection, and it's the DTaP, children under 7 and adults. So if you need any more information, you can call the Monterey County Health Department. The number is 755-4500, or go into the Monterey County Health Department website. But get protected if you believe in getting immunizations. There's some people that are anti-immunizations, that's fine. But I'll tell you, I've worked as an immunization nurse for many years, and I have received my immunizations, and I never had any child ever have any side effects from an immunization. But again, I'm just reminding the community about that, Mayor.
Okay.
And that we up here need to get our immunizations.
Do you have to be well before you get a flu shot?
Yes, you shouldn't have a temperature.
Can we talk further? My wife assured me I did not have a whooping cough. I asked. All right. All right, with that, we will proceed to the redevelopment agency and city council consent item. There are 5 items on city council and 2 on the redevelopment. Would anyone on the council like anything pulled?
Minutes. The minutes, please. The item minutes. Number 1.
Done. Anyone else?
Okay, I'm going to have to recuse myself on item 3, so I will make that announcement.
Mr. Mayor, I think the gentleman that was here, did he say number 5?
Is he? Okay.
Yeah.
Flag that for him. And just anyone else on council on anything? Okay, we'll put a tentative flag on number 5 on behalf of the public. Any other items from the public? Okay, we will go ahead and start with council. Councilmember Barnes on item 1.
I'd just like to clarify the record for the minutes. It's a little convoluted because the motion was. I'm voting aye on City Council Consent Resolution number 3. No, my no vote was on the motion to approve staff's recommendation on City Council Consent Resolution item 4, which was opposing the League's Policy Resolution number 3. My no vote on City Council Consent Resolution 4 is consistent with my comments in opposition to continue implementation of AB 32, SB 375 due to the unfunded mandates.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Is the gentleman still here on 5? There you are, right in front of me. That is always a bad place to look.
they sent me a detailed sketch of the raised media island in between Curtis and Chaparral. They're saying they're going to redo the sidewalk to go straight through, you know, on that little island part right there. What I want to see possibly happen is, instead of putting the bus stop right in front of my house where it is now, if they could move that bus stop to that median where they're going to redo that little section of land. The bus stop would be about 70 feet north of where it is now, right at the, right past the intersection of Curtis. And what would, that would allow is me not having to fight the bus trying to get in my driveway. And that's been
hard to fight with. Okay.
That's been an issue for years.
Okay, hang tight for a moment. I hear the city manager talking under his breath, so we'll take that in the form of a question, so just hang tight and we'll address that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, and thank you for coming and bringing it to our attention. Okay, any other comments on five? Artie, how would you like to handle that?
I think I'll let Frank address it. I know the area, he and I have talked about it a number of times, and so Frank, is that something we can do in terms of, I'm sure we'd have to get with MST to see about moving the bus stop, but if we can accommodate that in the new design, I'm open to that.
Moving a stop sign would be also having to go to a traffic commission, I believe, so we can address it, look further into it.
Okay, let me just check with. So, how would you recommend we proceed on item five? Approve subject to further.
I think that this is sort of just a referral to staff to see if we can accommodate the relocation that's being requested. But I think it's kind of separate from the actual vote that you have.
So we'll just treat it as a council referral
to look at those issues through the traffic commission, if that's appropriate. And Frank, maybe you can get this gentleman's name and contact info so we can follow up.
Good. All right. Thank you.
So, Mr. Mayor, so I'll understand correctly here. If we approve number five, we will still be able to look at his situation.
Right. Yeah. Basically, what we're saying is we want to go ahead and approve to get things moving, and that the city manager has agreed to sit down with the resident and then take a look at it on a good faith basis.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, with that, what I'd like to do, because I need to recuse myself from number three, I'll look for a motion to approve 1, 2, 4, and 5, and then the redevelopment agency agendas, and then we'll just take three separately for the council.
Move to approve.
Second.
Okay.
Councilmember Burns?
Aye.
Councilmember Barrera?
Aye.
Councilmember De La Rosa?
Aye.
Councilmember Lewitz?
Aye.
Councilmember Sanchez?
Yes.
Councilmember Villegas?
Aye.
Mayor Donahue?
Yes. Okay, is there a motion to approve three?
Move approval.
Second.
Okay, call for the question.
Councilmember Burns?
Aye.
Councilmember Barrera?
Aye.
Councilmember De La Rosa?
Aye.
Councilmember Lewitz?
Aye.
Councilmember Sanchez?
Yes.
Councilmember Villegas?
Aye.
Okay, very good. Thank you, everyone. With that, we're going to have a real live public hearing, and with our favorite police chief, who will leave the meeting with more decorations on behalf of the department than he came in with.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, members of the council, and citizens of Salinas. The council report that you have before you is a request to hold a public hearing on the Citizens Option for Public Safety grant. That's federal dollars that comes from the feds through the state and then apportioned out to police agencies around the state based on a population formula. In this particular case, the amount that we will be receiving, if it is approved, will be $100,000, and the only restriction on that funding is that it be used for frontline law enforcement services. So it's very broad in its application. So we have lots of latitude as to how to use this money.
Very good. Any questions from council? Councilmember Villegas.
Sorry, Chief.
That's all right.
Did we have any unexpended funds from the last grant that we got from them at all?
My understanding is we do not.
Okay. So then that answers my next question. We didn't have to return any either.
Right.
Okay. Thank you.
I would have been very disappointed in the chief if we had to return anything. All right. Anyone from the public? Okay. Back to council. Councilmember Barrera.
When we're ready, move to approve.
Okay. Is there a second?
Second.
All right. Ann?
Councilmember Burns?
Aye.
Councilmember Barrera?
Aye.
Councilmember De La Rosa?
Aye.
Councilmember Lutz?
Aye.
Councilmember Sanchez?
Yes.
Councilmember Villegas?
Aye.
Mayor Donahue?
Yep. All right, we ran the table. Okay, with that, we're gonna proceed to an item I've been waiting for all week. Industrial wastewater treatment facilities. Frank, you're on. Because they are way more exciting than important than people realize. No pressure, Frank.
He just needs to take the cap off.
Mr. Mayor, Council Members, Frank Aguayo, Senior Engineer. Previously, earlier this year, the City Council approved negative declaration for the industrial wastewater conveyance system. And this is a similar approval. So we have the RON system with the MC Group to make this presentation. So Ron, with that, here's Ron. Here is the click.
Thank you, Frank. Mayor, council members, I think Frank kind of encapsulated what we're doing here pretty quickly, but let me go through this briefly. We are looking tonight at your request to adopt a mitigated negative declaration for some improvements to the industrial waste treatment facility. Let's talk about those a little bit and get some background real quick. Basically, at this point in time, the city can no longer dispose of industrial wastewater into the Salinas River. As of 2002, new requirements, we've got to percolate it on site or evaporate it on site. This is the main driver for a series of improvements that are being proposed at the facility to accommodate this issue. The other part of this is that by making these improvements, we'll restore some waste treatment capacity at the plant that's been eroded over time as sediments have filled into the evaporation ponds and things of that nature. City has undertaken a number of studies to evaluate how to do this, what improvements are appropriate, how to phase those, and some things about the costs of those improvements. Here's what we're doing briefly. We're removing some sludge, energy efficiency improvements, rehabilitating some existing facilities, and you see a range of other ancillary improvements. Main point is that these are really designed around improving the operation of the plant as it exists under its existing permitted capacity, no expansion of its treatment capacity, et cetera. All the improvements would take place within the existing boundary of the treatment plant, so nothing outside of that property. Get a little sense of the property itself or the site. Yellow line defines the treatment facility itself, percolation ponds and aeration beds for the most part. Down by the river, I think probably all of you are somewhat familiar with where this is off of South Davis Road. Apologies for the scale. I think you have this in your packet, but this essentially is a summary of the types of improvements that would be made and the locations where they'll be made within the site. A little bit about funding. Somewhat similar circumstance to the conveyance system. City has applied for federal funding of some of these improvements. The main source is the Clean Water State Revolving Fund. We've already made application as the city. We're looking for some low interest loans or hopefully some forgiven loan principal from the state on this. Portion of this will likely be funded by incremental rate increases to the users, to be determined what those will be at this point. One of the key things we need to look for is what is the state willing to ante up here, so we know what we need to make up locally in terms of costs. Project will be phased only to be implemented as funds become available. Like the conveyance project, the purpose of tonight is to adopt this environmental document. The state needs this document before they can make a decision about awarding loan or other types of funds to the city. So this is the linchpin. We're not acting on the project itself. We're acting only on the environmental document that accompanies the project. Okay. We went through the CEQA process. I won't bore you too much with the details, but there were some biological issues out there, potential effects on the river. We're not modifying the river, anything next to it. It's off-site. These are indirect possibilities if there's some erosion that drains to the river. There are U.S. Army Corps of Engineers and California Department of Fish and Game permit requirements likely for this project. This is habitat, potential habitat area for some special status species. We've done some work out there. Upshot of all this is we've got mitigations in the document that